to process the trauma of what we've been through. And I mean that in terms of the failure of the federal government in a profound way, in a way that the framers couldn't even contemplate. I mean, it's not science fiction. The country is beset by a serious, deadly virus. And the response of the federal government is to make light of it and then to pit the states off against each other for the political advantage of the individual who is in the highest office, to the point that the states had to find paramilitary ways of securing the protective equipment, the PPE that they needed. So Trump actually, instead of acting as someone that was a shield to help the states, actually became a nemesis, in some ways as threatening as the virus itself. That's pretty much unprecedented, where you had the federal government in some way make war on the states. In that void, to the eternal credit of Governor Cuomo, Governor Murphy, Governor Wolf, they pulled together, Governor Lamont in Connecticut, pulled together and came up with a compact, which I believe historians will see as significant as what happened with the 13 colonies. In essence, saying, we've got a problem, we're going to have an alternative narrative and describe what happened. Now, there's all kinds of things that Cuomo did, including taking the victory lap for the pandemic that wasn't successfully defeated, and his personal picadillos. But that historical moment where the states recognized that there was a threat the federal government wasn't dealing with was essential. And so I think that that's going to be to Murphy's credit. However, during Trump's tenure, Governor Murphy is kind of vacillated depending on how he reads the room. And so there can be an argument made that some of those ways that he rushed down there to be at the president's knee didn't send quite the right message. And then also now, you know, the governor, in terms of the mask mandate, that TikTok has revealed some of the stuff. In May, the CDC lifts the mandate without really surprises everyone. And then de Blasio and Cuomo follow suit. And Murphy, to his credit, listened to the unions and held off for a number of days. And then he himself said that, feeling the pressure from states that had dropped the requirement for masking, he felt he had to follow suit because he noted that people who wanted to go dine at a restaurant without a mask could simply just cross, you know, either river. And so I guess that's the dynamic that we've constantly had here, is this sense of the need to try to, because remember, Trump got a lot of votes in New Jersey. People forget that. It's not as blue a state as people think.